Journalism and activism are not mutually exclusive. Here on yourworldnews.org.
I wanted to, if you could start off by giving, you know, our viewers, our listeners, a history of Africom. I believe it started under the Bush administration and it was greatly expanded upon by the Obama administration, and it still continues to go on. But what is Africom? When did it start? And what is its primary objective?
Yeah, technically, Africom started under the Bush administration at the tail end of the Bush administration in 2008. But essentially, this was an Obama administration project. Africom under Obama went from 3 small military bases in Africa to 84 bases. And, you know, it depends on what you call a base and what you call a depot, or what you call a temporary training facility. The U.S. military has so many different ways to name the same thing in order to confuse people. But there's no doubt that the United States has basically penetrated all of Africa, except until recently, Eritrea. Otherwise, in terms of military agreements, all of them have signed up at some level with Africom, and an increasing number of them have large facilities in their country. There's been some protest, some pushback by Africans to the expanding, ever-expanding nature of Africa in Africom. In Ghana recently, there was a series of demonstrations when it was discovered that public facilities in Ghana were being turned over for Africom's use. And so that created a furor for a little while. But nothing that matches that is a real response to the huge expansion of this military occupation in many ways of Africa. Because you have to understand that even the peacekeeping missions in Africa that are nominally under the African Union are really funded, certainly funded by the Europeans and the United States, but on the ground, militarily, they're run by the CIA and AFRICOM. So the U.S. military presence isn't just limited to U.S. military personnel on the ground. The United States has successfully infiltrated, I think that really is the sense of the word, infiltrated African militaries through AFRICOM to the extent that you can count most of those African armies as extensions of U.S. military power and Africa.